So to sum up with this respiratory pathology, let's see how to approach a patient with lung cancer. So the patient will be presenting chronic cough, and he will be having hemoptysis, and also weight loss will be there. So these are the features by which patient is presenting. Now what we have to go for certain investigations like radiology and also the sputum examination, and also we have to look for the biopsy, bronchoscopic biopsy. Now after that you should look the microscopic examination and also immunohistochemistry. So in the microscopic examination, one thing which you can see, it is keratin. You can see either keratin or you can see intercellular bridge. So all this are seen in which type of carcinoma? Squamous cell carcinoma. Now the other one you can see, it is about glands. That means you will be seeing mucin and glands. So that is actually adenocarcinoma. Now the other one which you are seeing, it is, you can see small blue cells and neurosecretory granules. So that is in small cell carcinoma. And you are not seeing any of these features, diagnosis of exclusion, then it will be large cell carcinoma. So first of all, patient presented with certain clinical features, then whatever investigations which we have to give, do. And after that, what about after taking the biopsy, from that slide you have to go for a microscopic examination of that slide and immunohistochemistry of that slide, by which how can it be a squamous cell carcinoma when there will be keratin pearls or intercellular bridges like that. That is actually poorly differentiated, well differentiated, but as a whole it is squamous cell carcinoma. And when it is adenocarcinoma, glands will be there, mucin will be there. And when it is small cell carcinoma, we know how it just looks like, the salt and pepper pattern, the neurosecretory granules, and there will be impression, what nucleus is having impression on the other. So we have studied that. Now as a diagnosis of exclusion, large cell carcinoma also. Now what about the immunohistochemistry? In the immunohistochemistry, first of all, we know it is squamous cell carcinoma. How can you, what do you see? What are the markers that will be positive? P40 will be positive and P63 will be positive. So P40 will be positive and P63 will be positive. So we have studied that in detailed explanation of squamous cell carcinoma, isn't it? Okay, now in adenocarcinoma, what are the markers that you can see? Thyroid transcription factors, and you can see NAPA. So all this will be positive. So in small cell carcinoma, you can see chromogranin. Chromogranin will be positive because it is having neurosecretory granules. Okay, that's why. Now, what about large cell carcinoma? In large cell cancer also, you will be getting this chromogranin and synaptophysin positive. Okay, so P40 and P63 positive in squamous cell carcinoma. So we already found the microscopic examination. Now by this immunohistochemistry, you can confirm it. Okay. So P40 and P63 positive in squamous cell carcinoma, and thyroid transcription factor and NAPCIN A positive in adenocarcinoma, and the chromogranin can be positive in both small cell and large cell carcinoma. The thyroid transcription factor will be positive here also. So that's why more specifically here you can look for this NAPCIN A. Okay. So that's all about this. How to approach a patient with lung cancer. Thank you.